12 years old, and my dad's always been like a super entrepreneur. He's always bought businesses, built them up, sold them, you know, always changed. He's always been a fireman, but he always did things extra. Try to give us just a good life, you know? I don't have like a rough upbringing. I never was like I was like a spoiled rich kid. I never had any like tough in the hood, like never anything like that. So, but my dad worked his ass off, you know? He'd work at the fire department. He always was, he's a realtor and owned several different kinds of businesses, me growing up. Anyways, we walk into this building he was looking to acquire, and on the wall, there was a slogan, live a life worth living and work a job worth working. And I was like, wow. I was 12 years old, like, God, and it just stuck with me. And I kind of just made it like my mantra, man, like live a life worth living, man, for sure. Like, why? It's so short and so, you know, what happens when it's over? What happens when you're in it? A lot of people are in it and they're dead. You know, they're so used to the day-to-day monotony of just wake up, go to work, come home, go to bed, you know? And it's like, fuck that. Fuck that. Come and live and hang on the ranch, you also have to put the work in. You don't get to just show up and play. So the guys come and they work, you know. Many hands make light work. It's a true statement, man. And we just attack a situation or attack a job, we usually get it done kind of speedy. So we're building a new house on the new property. But before that, the baby's coming, right? It's on his way. So I have to get the two kids new rooms in the old house, which means my old bar, I had to do something with all the stuff. So I was like, well, I'll just build a new bar. And the wife was super stoked on that because she was like, instead of me building the new stuff, I went over and started building the bar. Yeah, we cranked that out in 3 weeks, man. It was incredible. I don't have many friends left after that because it was literally from the moment the sun came up till pretty much after it went down, because we had lights. So we were working long days, and anyone I could call to come help, helped. Anyone I could bribe with beer came. But it was in the peak of the quarantine, it was. So, which is another funny thing, is the quarantine to me, my life hasn't changed any. Still go to Home Depot. Still going on the gas station, still go to Walmart. Other than that, we kind of hang at the ranch all day, man. There's not really, other than the lakes being closed, which they just reopened, it's kind of the only thing change. I mean, maybe an occasional gym run to another gym to train with people here and there. Maybe the mall or the Apple store. A couple little dumb things. You know, the wife's going crazy because she's stuck here. Yeah, on a day-to-day life, man, it's like sun up, pretty much sun down. Summertime, it's way busier because we have, of course, more light, and it's not cold. So we have like a million projects. And every day we wake up, we're like, what are we doing today? And then we just decide. We don't really ever have planned. Some projects overtake others. Like right now, we're hanging a bunch of drywall, and I hate drywall, so I try to do anything I can other than drywall. But unfortunately, end of the week's looking like that's where we're going. That pattern's gonna come in from that room. So this one's closed.
Okay. So it's 119. I just wanted to see what 16 foot would hit if we had a 16 footer for a step.
I gotta put a door in.
Yeah. Okay.
met Jonah at Zach Brown band, country singer. Lindsay, my wife, and Desiree, his wife, are doctors, and they work together. Desiree brought John. We were backstage on the bus with Zach, and he was like blown away, like, who the fuck are you? Like, how are we? Like, he had no idea anything, right? And he asked me if I ever wanted to go hunting. We started like hanging out. He came to the ranch, and then he was an electrician. And I needed something, so I called Desiree and asked him to come up. And then he's been working for me for about 3 years now. And he's a fucking hardworking dude, man. Like, hardworking dude. And it's hard to find people like that. And so he's always stuck around. He's one of those guys that he said it's hard to get into our group, but once you're in, you're in. And I'm a fucker. He's a good dude, for sure. Life and my career, everybody is born and they grow old and then they get their money and they retire. And I've always looked at that like it was backwards. Like, why do I want to make all this money, put it in an account, and then when I'm 60, try to go race a four-wheeler, ride on a boat, snowmobile, jet ski, skydive? At that age, I'm be like, I'd rather just watch somebody else do it, you know? So I like am in a situation where I make good money and I kind of want to live my life in reverse. So I feel like I'm retired right now, you know? And that's why I live life to the fullest, man, because I don't want to one day when I'm 50 or 60 try to attempt all these things I want to do. Like, God, I'm 60. I'm going to build a racetrack. And I'm going to try and get my old ass on this Banshee and rip it. And it ain't going to look good. It ain't going to happen. The crashes are going to hurt way worse, right? So I just am retired now is how I look at it.
What's the time to beat?
155.
155.
Jonah got 105.
205.
205. I got 105.
This
is so sick. He was already at 140 on the other bike coming in here.
What is he there?
42.
Oh, shit.
Probably I get better 2 minutes. 47, 48. Oh, shit, he might. I think he'll be up there 5 seconds. Wow. On a bike he's never ridden.
Never ridden.
157.
2 seconds.
2 seconds, that's it? On a bike I've never even ridden?
Yep, that's exactly what he just said.
Fucking, this bike's so fast for a 250.
It is,
Christ.
On third gear, I was picking it up when I was ramping, landing.
That is cool.
Heck yeah.
Try to pull a fatty out here.
Anybody else want to do a time?
Yeah. I don't think your clock has that many seconds.
Hey. Hey, it's all good.
Okay, cool. Word.
I'm gonna do one more run with them and.
Life worth living, man. Just all day, every day. Like whenever we have new people come out here and train, that's what we try to teach.